And finally, we're going to play the exact same trick that we did for combinational circuits, and we're just going to keep adding layers of complexity. So once we have individual registers, we can put multiple registers together with some read and write ports in order to create register files. So here is a register file. We implement writes using a clock signal that comes in, and then we'll have a register number that says, you know, which register we want to write to, and then we'll have the data that we are actually trying to write, and we'll use a decoder, which is a component that we didn't talk about last time, but I did a little demo with Logisim, and you can go look at one of those in that video if you want. It's also in the file that I'm distributing on Canvas. But basically what this does is it takes the register number and it turns it into a bunch of on-off signals where there are as many on-off signals as there are registers. And so basically we've now got a set signal for each of these registers. And that set signal is going to be combined with the clock signal just to make sure that we're doing everything synchronized with the clock. And of course, we're going to take the data and feed the data into each of these registers. And so basically, whichever register we're writing to on this cycle, that's the only one that is going to have the set bit turned on at the rising of the clock signal. And so that's the only one that's actually going to change. On the read side, we'll have all the registers that are in our register file, and we'll pass in two register values. So in a single cycle, we can write one register, or we can read up to two registers. And we're basically just going to use two multiplexers in order to pull out the two values that we want. So it'll pull out the first value, and it'll pull out the second value. And those could be the same register, but that's generally how all that works. This is a way of abstracting a register file, so you don't have to look at all the details inside. And I just want to highlight that this is slightly different between the version in the PDF that we distributed on Canvas, which is from a textbook different than your textbook, and this is the version from your textbook. So here we have the register numbers for reading coming in, and then we've got all the writing information coming in. So we've got all of the inputs over here on the left, and then we've got the read outputs coming out on this side, and the clock signal coming in from the bottom. The one in your textbook is the same, it's just drawn slightly differently. It has the inputs and the outputs for the reading on this side, and then it's got the writing stuff coming in on this side. So it's just different ways of laying out the various inputs and outputs, but it's essentially the same component. And again, this is an abstraction that just combines a bunch of different registers together with some multiplexers and decoders in order to implement the register file. This is memory, and so of course we can implement random access memory as well using this, so that we have this large bank of memory, and we can access any address at any time by using the same scheme that we did for the register files. So we can have a decoder and a selector or multiplexer, and then each of these circuits in the middle are essentially registers with their combinations of flip-flops. And assuming that we can manufacture these relatively cheaply, then we can have as much memory as we can manufacture here. And we'll need to expand the decoder and the selector accordingly, right? We need to have however many elements we have in our memory, we'll need log base 2 of decoder and selector bits in order to address all of that memory. Yeah, and so that's basically back up to the top, right? We have this abstraction where we have basically memory that is data for our program, and now we can take that and we can put it on a component and let it talk to the CPU, and that will be that can be our RAM. And so now we have sort of this almost complete picture that we're going to fill in all the details next time about how all these things actually talk to each other and how the signals get decoded and everything. But we've talked about most of these individual components already. We have our ALU, we have our data memory, we have our register file, and we've got some other pieces that we'll fill in next time. But hopefully the picture is starting to become clearer and clearer about how we can start from these very, very basic logic gates and build it all the way up into these really, really complicated, very capable machines simply by utilizing abstraction and designing our circuits very carefully.